Hello, everyone. I want to begin by thanking Prime Minister Draghi for welcoming us to Rome for this G20. There's always been a tremendously strong partnership between Italy and Canada, strong people-to-people ties, growing trade ties, and shared values, of course, are the cornerstone of our friendship and relationship. I also want to highlight that it was a moment in this G20 to recognize the incredible leadership that Angela Merkel has shown over the past 16 years as Chancellor. She has been such a strong voice on so many big international issues, a voice of strength, of wisdom, and she's been personally a really good friend to me and a font of advice, wisdom, and probing questions that have always helped me be more effective on the world stage. Le Canada est évidemment prêt à continuer de travailler avec nos partenaires du G20 sur les grands enjeux auxquels notre monde fait face. On est là pour collaborer, pour surmonter les grands défis ensemble, et c'est de ça dont nous avons discuté pendant ces rencontres aujourd'hui et hier. Of course, the big issue that we continued to address first was the recovery from COVID-19. We know that to beat COVID anywhere, we have to beat it everywhere, which is why we announced that Canada will donate 200 million doses to COVAX by the end of 2022. We're investing $15 million to the COVAX Manufacturing Task Force to support a tech transfer hub in South Africa. We've paid our fair share on the ACT Accelerator for testing, and we've also announced $982 million from special drawing rights to IMF's Poverty Reduction and Growth Trust, which will help the developing world recover from the impacts of this pandemic and grow the economies in positive ways for tomorrow. The big theme as well, speaking of tomorrow and the day after and the week to come, it was COP26. And discussions on the environment and the fight against climate change were woven through our sessions, in addition to the main session this morning on climate change and the environment. In 2015, Canada signed on to the Paris Agreement and made strong commitments about being a climate leader, not just at home, but in encouraging others around the world to continue to step up. Since then, we've brought in a strong, broad-based price on pollution. We've invested in clean tech and renewable energy. We've protected more of our land and oceans than ever before. When we came into office in 2015, just 1% of our coasts and oceans were protected. We're now at 14% and well on our way to 25% by 2025 and 30% by 2030. On a aussi parlé de la responsabilité que nous avons tous d'éliminer le charbon, réduire l'utilisation et éliminer le charbon, de limiter nos émissions de méthane. Le Canada a pris des actions concrètes au cours des dernières années. Nous n'allons plus produire d'électricité par le charbon d'ici 2020. Et nous encourageons le monde à faire pareil, mais nous allons être là pour investir, pour aider le monde à en faire moins. Nous sommes commis à doubler notre financement pour le climat. We've doubled our climate financing commitment, a commitment we made in Paris that we've now doubled, and we've been working with partners like Germany and others to ensure that the world steps up to that $100 billion for climate financing that we know is going to be necessary if developing countries are able to be part of this transition, which we need them to be, or we face the catastrophic impacts of climate change. On a aussi parlé du rôle du secteur privé dans la lutte contre les changements climatiques. Il y a évidemment des profits à faire pour le secteur privé, mais surtout il y a des investissements qui vont être bons pour la planète que les différentes multinationales, le secteur privé est intéressé à faire. Le Canada fait partie de plusieurs groupes qui sont en train d'essayer d'encourager des investissements du privé dans la lutte contre les changements climatiques et on va continuer de le faire. Obviously, you can't come to a G20 without talking about trade. Strengthening and deepening progressive trade around the world continues to be one of the big goals that Canada has, as we've signed a number of strong trade deals over the past number of years that are really coming into their own. In my visit here to Italy and on Friday in the Netherlands. We talked a lot about how CETA in particular has increased opportunities both for Canadian businesses and businesses here in Europe to create deeper connections and more positive outcomes. We're going to continue to push on that for more good jobs and growth, which are good for the small and medium-sized businesses, good for workers, good for all of our economies. This G20 has been a lot of hard work, and we'll continue to do that work tomorrow with partners from around the world as we go to Glasgow to fight for a cleaner environment and fight against climate change. I'm looking forward to getting to it.